I was 9 when Zama won her 2 gold medals. I would have given anything to stand in her shoes. I didn't want it for myself. I wanted it for my coach. He chose me when I was 5 years old. He believed in me more than I believed in myself. But then one day at practice, I walked in and he was talking to the other girls. He said something about the chubby one. The girls looked at me, and I suddenly realized he means me. I couldn't believe it. I only weigh 40 kilos. After practice, he said I had to lose 2 kilos for Olympic trials. First, I cut out sugar, then dairy, then fat. But it was hard to lose weight. I had so little body fat, I started losing muscle. I counted out my calories, only 600 a day, even though my body needed 3 times as much for training. It was hard in the beginning, but it got easier. The sight of food made me sick. I told my mother I was too tired to eat. If I was this disciplined about food, I deserved to win. When I dropped the 2 kilos, my coach was really happy. So was our costume designer. But I had to keep it off. You've seen Olympic gymnasts. They are not fat. Then one day, I lost my balance on an easy dismount. I lied and said I was up too late the night before. My coach sent me home to think about how serious I was about my training. How serious? I was so serious, I was starving myself. My mother knew. She would cry and scream at the dinner table until I ate 4 bites. There was no way I was giving up on my dream now that I was so close to it. Then one day, my arms gave out during a practice vault and I hit my head. I guess my muscles and bones were weak from malnutrition and there wasn't enough time to fix it. The Olympic trials were coming up. My coach was disappointed in me and started training an alternate. My mother was furious and screamed. It was all his fault. I was never chubby. I went to the hospital where the doctors put me on IV drip and strict diet. I stared at that sugar pouring into my veins. After a month in the hospital, I gained 3 kilos. I went home and had a normal life for a while. My mom and I watched Beijing on TV. Shawn Johnson, Sandra Izbasha, Nastya Lukin. I couldn't help but wonder, what if I had been there? Would things have gone differently? My mother was afraid to let me train again, but we found a new coach, and she's incredible. I feel strong and confident. I can finally land a triple backflip off the uneven bars. So, when you watch Olympic Games in 2012, pay attention. You may be hearing the Ukrainian national anthem.